Welcome. You're watching Commodity Masterclass, an initiative by ICICI Direct. And I have a very special guest with me tonight. And she is Ms. Mamta Kapila, AVP Business Development, MCX. Welcome, Mamta.
Thank you very much, Geetu, and thank you for having me here.
My pleasure. How can one trade on MCX and what are the exchange timings?
For a client to trade on MCX, they can come through members. So we have registered members, like ICICI Direct is also one of our registered members. Mm-hmm. So a client need to ensure that he's trading through a SEBI and MCX registered members and not on an illegal platform like Dabba. Okay. So that is one way to come and trade on MCX. So the timing changes from summer to winter. In summer, it is till from 9 till 11:30 and winter, it is from 9 till 11:55.
Right. What commodities and products are available for trading on multi-commodity exchange?
So we have four product segments. So we have a bullion, we have base metals, we have agri commodities, and then we have energy segment. And we have basically three products. That is, like, we have got futures on commodities. Mm-hmm. Then we have indices. Mm-hmm. And the third product we have got is options.
Okay. So if one has to trade, I mean, which of the three categories that you just, spoke about, the options available, which of the categories is garnering the maximum volumes as of now?
So when it comes to dates, so we started with the commodity futures. So from 2003 onwards, commodity futures were what was being traded on the exchange. Then when SEBI came into the picture in 2015, a lot of development started happening. So from 2017 onwards, options came into the picture. So, and indices were launched last year only. So we have two indices, mm-hmm. sectoral indices, Bulldex and Metaldex. So mm-hmm. they were launched in 2020. So the volume also coming from the retailer and proprietary trade depends, because most of the trade would right now be coming from futures in commodities.
Okay. How about the future contracts actually settled on MCX?
So we have two kind of contract. One is a compulsory delivery contract, where a contract result into deliveries. Mm-hmm. And the second is a both option contract, where the deliveries is not taking place. Okay. So apart from four contracts, that is crude, natural gas, CPO and kapas, mm-hmm. all other contracts which are listed on the exchange are compulsory delivery contract. So in case of compulsory delivery contracts, the spot price of the last 3 days average is taken to settle the contract. So that becomes the final settlement price. And in case of the international contracts like crude and natural gas, we take the price from the international markets and multiply it by the RBI reference rate of that particular day. And that becomes the final settlement price at which the contracts get settled.
Okay. If, somebody has to take the delivery, is it possible for to take the delivery of the commodity one has traded? And if yes, how is the location decided and in which form can the delivery be taken?
Okay. The deliveries are possible to take, or like all our bullion contracts, our base metal contracts, they're all deliverable. Even in agri, we have commodities which are deliverable, like mentha, like rubber, mm-hmm. cardamom, so cotton, these are all our deliverable contracts. So the location depends on whichever is the biggest trading center or the production center. Like Ahmedabad is the biggest trading center when it comes to gold. So mm-hmm. the delivery center is Ahmedabad. We have got lots of additional delivery centers also, but our major delivery center is Ahmedabad. Now, when it comes to the form of delivery, the delivery takes place in the DMAT form. So like similar to equity segment, where delivery takes place in the DMAT form, in commodities also the delivery takes place in the DMAT form. Here we have two ways of the agri part. The non-agri deliveries are taken through Commerce, and the agri deliveries are taken through CCRL. Mm-hmm. So these are the two depositories through which the deliveries take place. And in a client's account, like in case of equity, he'll see that I've got these many shares of this particular company. Right. So in case of commodity, suppose let's say he has taken the delivery of gold. So mm-hmm. he'll be having like gold, and then there'll be a quantity along with it. Then there'll be a quality attached to it. And then there'll be a location, because the gold would actually be lying in a particular warehouse or a vault. Right. So the location also plays a very important role, mm-hmm. and quality as well.
Mm-hmm. Which index derivative is available for trading on multi-commodity exchange right now?
Last year, we launched two sectoral indices. One was Bulldex, which is a bullion index. The composition is gold and silver. And then the second one was metal decks, in which we have the base metal underlying is the base metal contracts. So these are the two indices which we launched last year.
How beneficial is to trade on in the index derivatives? I mean, how does it differ from the spot, the future market, and the index derivative? What would be
Sorry.
more beneficial?
Index derivatives, what we have is only a few. We have right now the futures on indices. So we have three, like how people trade in Nifty. So they can trade in BullDex as well as MetalDex. So then there are three monthly contracts which are available. So the advantages are these are smaller denominational contracts which attract retailers because there is less margin. Then they are cash settled, so there are no deliveries because there are lots of retailers who do not want to take deliveries. Then if they add, if these indices are added to their portfolios, so they diversify their portfolio. Suppose you are holding an equity only in your portfolio, so they are going to diversify your portfolio as well as they are going to diversify the risk because they are itself a basket of a commodities. Like bullion index is a basket of gold and silver combination, and base metal index is a basket of all the five base metals we have got.
So if we talk about the bullion basket, so what is the kind of contracts that we have? You said you have small mini contracts also there.
Yeah, in gold we have four contracts. We have a gold 1 kg contract, and then we have a gold mini contract, which is a 100 gram contract. Then we have a gold guinea contract, which is an 8 gram contract, and we have a gold petal contract, which is a 1 gram contract. And all these contracts are deliverable. So if somebody wants to invest in a smaller contract, they can even take deliveries in demat form for a 1 gram gold also.
Is it same for silver too?
Silver, we have got three contracts. So we have got a silver major contract, which is a 30 kg contract. And then we have a silver mini, which is a 5 kg contract. And we have a silver micro, which is a 1 kg contract. And similarly, these silver contracts are also deliverable. So the delivery, the major center for both these gold and silver is Ahmedabad. But we have additional delivery centers also. So mostly the delivery takes place from Ahmedabad. And since it's in DMAT form, it doesn't matter because a person sitting anywhere in India can take delivery and it'll be transferred to his DMAT account and he can easily sell it on the exchange again.
And what are the constituents of your metal index, and how many metals do you trade in those index?
So we have a bullion index, like I said, which we call BullDex. So we have got gold and silver in that. And then we have a metal index called base metal index called MetalDex, in which there are five components. What is copper, zinc, aluminium, nickel.
Are they deliverable again?
The index is not deliverable. Index is a cash settled contract, but these base metal contracts are all deliverable. So from 2019 onwards, all these base metal contracts became deliverable. Earlier, they used to be cash settled, but 2019 onwards, these base metal contracts became deliverable. And we have seen a huge amount of hedgers participating in our platform since that these contracts became deliverable.
I was just about to ask, I mean, after this becoming deliverable, have the corporates started approaching and coming on MCX to really trade into these commodities and hedge themselves?
Yes, they have. SEBI came, MCX was started being regulated by SEBI from 2015 onwards. And there have been tremendous developments since then. Like 2017, I was telling you, options came into the picture. Then banks were allowed, like ICICI Direct is a bank. So the bank subsidiaries were allowed in 2017. 2019, mutual funds were allowed to participate. So through mutual fund, there'll be a lot of retailers who may not be participating directly on the exchange, but then indirectly they can come through mutual funds. Then 2019, the base metals contract started with the deliveries. So a lot of hedgers who were hesitant maybe earlier because it was a cash settled contract, so they started participating. And 2020, the commodity indices were launched. So it's been a good journey, and there have been a lot of developments in the recent past.
Right. How are complaints put forth by clients and handled by MCX?
So from where we started, a client has to understand that they need to trade through registered brokers only. Because if they are trading through Dabba, which is illegal, so then there is no redressal system for that. So they cannot go to the police, they cannot complain to the exchange because they have got no documentation. So a client needs to ensure when they're opening the account, they're filling their KYC properly. They have mentioned their email address, which is correct. They have mentioned their mobile number, which is correct. So in case still, if they face any kind of issues, any kind of problems with the members they are trading through, they can always come to the exchange to put a complaint. They can go to SEBI. So there is a whole redressal mechanism which is there through which their complaints are addressed.
Right. Thank you, Kapila, for your time. It was a pleasure speaking with you.
Thank you, Geetu. It was nice being here.